Over 98% of our genome consists of non-coding DNA. And while certain repetitive regions were once colloquially regarded as genetic junk, we have since come a long way since this oversimplified perception, and now know that the non-coding genome is teeming with genetic activity. From long and small non-coding RNAs to transposons and pseudogenes, the non-coding genome is a dynamic substrate that is involved in wide-ranging biological and pathological processes. However, despite increasing interest in the non-coding genome, we are far from understanding the full extent of its impact on human health and disease. Our review article entitled "Processed Pseudogenes, a Substrate for Evolutionary Innovation," takes a deep dive into the non-coding genome and argues that through the activity of line 1 retrotransposons, processed pseudogenes disperse coding and non-coding sequences rich with regulatory potential throughout the human genome. While these sequences may appear to be non-functional, a lack of contemporary function does not prohibit future development of biological activity. Here we discuss the dynamic evolution of certain processed pseudogenes into coding and non-coding genes and regulatory elements, and their implication in wide-ranging biological and pathological processes. Currently, there are over 14,000 annotated pseudogenes littered throughout our genome. That is almost the same as protein-coding genes. Amongst the tens of thousands of pseudogenes, there are three classes: duplicated, unitary, and processed pseudogenes. Here we focus on the most abundant class of pseudogenes, processed pseudogenes, which arrive through the activity of L1 retrotransposons. In rare instances, active L1 retrotransposons can hijack transcripts in the cellular vicinity of the L1 retrotransposition machinery. These transcripts are chaperoned and incorporated into new genomic locations, resulting in the generation of stripped-down processed pseudogenes devoid of parental regulatory elements and introns. Although processed pseudogenes are relatively abundant in the human genome, we know comparatively little about the extent of their functional relevance. And this is largely due to technical challenges in studying pseudogenes with highly similar sequences to their parent genes. Our understanding of pseudogenes is also stymied by the implied bias in the term pseudogene, which immediately assumes non-functionality. A combination of these two hurdles have meant that pseudogenes are often overlooked and underappreciated when it comes to biomedical research. In our review article, we discuss how the genomics revolution first brought to our attention that thousands of pseudogenes are actively transcribed in ubiquitous tissue or cancer-specific patterns. This breakthrough finding gave new meaning to the term pseudogene and led researchers to question how these bare-bone gene copies, lacking regulatory elements, can firstly become transcribed and secondly develop expression patterns through coordinated regulation. The ability of pseudogenes to become transcribed is leveraged on regulatory element availability, and in most instances comes down to the genomic location of integration. If pseudogenes are inserted in or near genes or transposons, they can become transcribed by hitchhiking on nearby regulatory sequences. In some cases, adjacent sequences with high GC content and inherent proto-promoter properties can evolve into bona fide promoters and transcribe nearby pseudogenes. The recruitment of novel regulatory elements means, unlike duplicated pseudogenes, processed pseudogenes usually evolve functions that are distinct to their parent genes. Over time, transcribed processed pseudogenes can expand our genetic repertoire by generating fusion transcripts with nearby or host genes, leading to chimeric transcripts with distinct functions from the original host or parent gene. Exon gain is often accompanied over evolutionary time, with pseudogenes becoming multi-exonic through the exaption of flanking sequences or by the intronization through the acquisition of parentally derived splice sites. Following the discovery that pseudogenes are widely transcribed, we now know that processed pseudogenes can function through non-coding mechanisms to impact the genome. For example, pseudogenes can act as decoys for parent gene targeting microRNAs, as small interfering RNAs, as antisense transcripts that block parent gene translation, and as epigenetic modifiers. Advances in sequencing technologies have identified that many processed pseudogenes retain intact open reading frames and are potentially protein coding. Not surprisingly, there have been numerous accounts of functional protein coding pseudogenes producing truncated or full-length proteins relative to their parent genes. These pseudogenes often fulfill redundant functions or, under positive selection, can relocalize to different subcellular niches and evolve novel functions. It is important to note that the birth of novel functional pseudogenes is a rare event. However, through the course of evolutionary time, we propose that processed pseudogenes can act as a genetic reservoir for evolutionary innovation. Since processed pseudogenes are derived from protein-coding genes, their sequences may contain transcription factor binding motifs and higher GC content compared to intronic DNA. Under selective pressures, these processed pseudogenes could evolve proto-promoter properties and impact nearby genes. In other cases, some processed pseudogenes may retain one or more parentally derived introns, which could contain enhancer elements. Furthermore, some pseudogenes retain alternative transcriptional start sites embedded within their sequences, which can lead to the generation of chimeric pseudogene gene fusions. These are just a few examples which highlight the various ways that processed pseudogenes can act as a rich source of genetic information and provide opportunities for evolutionary innovation. So to summarize our review article, we liken the human genome to an evolutionary playground which facilitates the repurposing of ancestral coding sequences and the birth of novel genes and regulatory elements. We argue that far from evolutionary inert regions of the genome, some processed pseudogenes can facilitate genetic innovation given the appropriate time and selective pressures, ultimately contributing to the functional evolution of the human genome.